Here we have MDC, which emulates sanctions imposed in countries which have no respect in their own jurisdictions on the lives of black people. This is why we have organizations which say black lives matter. They forget that they are blacks. They forget that those who are oppressed in the United States elsewhere are black people. They have no regard for that. Now, what values are they seeking to import and practice in our country? Why can't they see for themselves that they are being misled, that there is no truth whatsoever in the United States propagating human rights elsewhere, when in fact they cannot practice such human rights in their own countries, against their own population? And I think the video of George Floyd, you are all aware of that, how a human being, a black person, is treated like he's just an animal, like he's a rat. The same party also, the MDC, under the late Morgan Tsvangirai, and I repeat this again and again to show the true DNA of MDC. Tsvangirai tore his party's own constitution to make illegal appointments of two additional vice presidents. These are the people who call themselves Democrats, yet they have no respect of their own constitution. How can they be trusted to respect the national constitution, I ask? Isn't this daylight hypocrisy? As if that is not enough, in 2018, one of the illegally appointed vice presidents violently usurped power following the death of Tsvangirai. To this day, it is known fact that Chamisa resorts to violence to gain political mileage within the MDCs, in full glare of the same Western embassies that clamor for human rights but have never uttered a word in condemnation of the violence perpetrated by its surrogates. This cannot go and continue unchallenged. Zimbabweans who ignore this violent streak in the MDCs will not have anyone but themselves to blame if they follow and pursue violent outfits and personalities. The law will be applied without fear or favor. Like I said last time, if they don't respect the law will not respect them. Now, ahead of the 2018 harmonized elections, Chamisa and Coates led a crusade of violent speeches during the campaign, threatening an imminent post-electoral violence in direct contrast to President E.D. Mnangagwa's call for peace, tolerance, love, unity, and violence-free elections. Go to the campaign speeches of our president and of Chamisa. Chamisa is spewing out violent threats. Our president is talking peace because he knows the consequences of violence, having been and he being an armed soldier himself. He knows what are the consequences of violence. Death will ensue. Throughout his campaign, Chamisa repeated the infamous anecdote, and I repeat, ndirikudira jecha musadza racho, tona kuti munoridya sei kana ndisina kuhwina, which literally meant that the MDC would engage in acts of sabotage and make the country ungovernable, something that is beginning to unfold. And addressing a rally at Mukoba Stadium in Gweru on the 23rd July 2018, again, Chamisa went on to say that, and I want to quote, "I will be serious. There will be serious consequences if my will does not prevail." End of quote. Addressing another rally at General Growth Point in Saka on the 14th, 2018, Chamisa threatened violence again, saying, and I quote, "I will bring into the streets guys from Baramusika who are ready for violence." End of quote. not to be outdone, Jendai Bitt, the now vice president of MDC Alliance, while addressing a rally in Mavuk-Tafara constituency on 26 June 2018, declared, and I quote, "The Alliance will not accept election results if ZANU-PF was the winner, again threatening violence in the event that ZANU-PF won the polls."